So represent these truths in your commitment to one another and living in unity sand. The symbolism in unity sand is pretty amazing, and it's something you can look at as a reminder for years to come. And simply put, like I just said, it is the center and foundation of your marriage. And it's a fantastic example and a great reminder to continually put your hope and trust in Him because it's nothing better. Go ahead. Hello.
Your love is like radiant diamonds bursting inside of me. We cannot contain. Your love will surely come find us like blazing wildfire. Sing your name, God among us. See love of mine. I have surrendered to your design. May this offering stretch across the skies. These hallelujahs be more.
To solidify your commitment to one another, you're supposed to exchange vows. Sin, you will release that commitment. I, sin, take you in to be my wife. I promise to be your loving and faithful husband. When in plenty and in want, when in good times and in bad times, when in sickness and in health, when our love is simple, and when it is in public. As your husband, I will strive to point to Christ in all that we do, till he returns or calls me home. I am going to take him to me, to be my husband. I promise to be your love is faithful, my friend. When it's ugly and in want, when it's good times and in bad, when it's sickness and in health, when our love is simple, and when it is an effort. As your wife, I will strive to point you to Christ in all that we do. So he returns or call him home. And to represent your love for each other, your rings. Okay? Rings are obviously very traditional at a wedding, but there's so much meaning. We've all seen a ring before. This is a very perfect circle. No death, no beginning, no end. It's a fantastic symbol of lifelong commitments. Once again, representing Christ in the church. As you place this ring on each other's finger, it is your covenant to love forever. So Tim, please take this ring. Repeat after me. Emily, with this ring, I pledge my love and life to you. Tim, with this ring, I pledge my love and my life to you. All right, here's the best part. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Tim and Emily, it is with great, great joy that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Tim, you may kiss your bride. It is my privilege that I get to announce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Tim and Emily Brandt. We clear the air.
I do it. ride is really easy, and I really didn't know. Okay, but yeah, I think the father has the hardest thing because he has to give away his daughter. So even though I didn't have to do a lot of the setup, I did have to give away my daughter. I think it's the hardest one. But if I like Tim, it makes it a little bit easier. Okay, but yeah. So that was my heart drop. And then, but I want to thank people, and I want to just start off by saying I know I won't thank everybody, because that's impossible, because I really don't even know everything that went into putting this wedding together. So I apologize ahead of time for forgetting people. So I just want to thank some people, like Cindy and Kenny. They were great, all the help they gave, and the encouragement, and for giving us Tim. And then my wife, who really handled a lot of the details and made sure things went smoothly, and she has some great friends that some of them are here now that have helped her and provided. So, and we have so many friends that did that. And then I also want to recognize my three beautiful daughters here, Rebecca, Christy, and Caitlin. You would stand.
Yeah.
to make her into the jewel that God wants her to be, and so now I know where to job now. Take that girl, and that's just what it said in Ephesians, what they read, that you're building her as a name of Christ. And now it's your job to take that jewel and to cut her and to protect her and to make her more like Christ. So just a couple things I want to say about her. One thing I love about Emily, she works hard. Always got a heart for her. Proverbs 31 says about this woman, she selects wool and flax and works with deep hands. That is not her. This girl works and she works with deep hands. So it's been a blessing to have her around and to have the woman that she is, that she's going to work. Another, in that chapter 2, there's another verse that says, she opens her arms to the poor and extends her hands to the needy. And there's hardly anyone I know more loving than her. She's so loving. She cares about everybody. She serves everybody. She's eager to do that. And then one more verse is, charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is truly praised. And she, is that beautiful?
Yes. Okay, that's beautiful.
She is more beautiful on the inside than she is on the outside. I'll tell you that right now.
Okay.
She is more beautiful on the inside than the outside. And that's why you need to take that girl if you need to help her. Just when you find that community and bring it out as God has done it. Two things, and then just one thing, I guess I'd like to say last is, there's a verse in the Bible, Jesus said, someone asked Jesus what's the greatest commandment, and Jesus says, to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your strength, and then to love your neighbor as yourself. And so I just want to challenge you, you guys who love God first, I love that you love each other. That doesn't matter. You love God first. When you put God first and you're in love with Jesus first, then you will be able to love each other when you're ready. So if you make that, you're going to love Jesus first, and then love each other second. So I just want to encourage you in that. And so, I don't know, they usually do a toast or something. I don't like a toast, because I would just really like to pray. Okay? So if you would just, with our toast, if they want to pray for these two, I'm going to do that. So I'm going to hold your hands. Okay. God, we just thank you for these two, and I just thank you for what you've done in their lives. God, I pray that you would help them to love you more than they can love each other, that they'd be able to love each other even better and love each other the way you want. That's a lot. I pray for Tim, that you would give him grace that he might really continue to work in Emily's life, to shape her into the image of Christ, to bring out that Christ-likeness, that beauty that's within her. And help Emily to encourage and respect him and to build him up and just to encourage and love him also. So thank you for this day and for these two. And God, it is the beginning of a great adventure of just knowing you better, loving each other, and serving you in the kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Just trying to wake me up, yelling at me, bugging me, and apparently I wouldn't move.
And so I started crying and she got really anxious, and my parents came downstairs and they said, "I'm leaving, are you okay?" And she said, "No, I need to go home." So my dad drove her home. And when she got home, she marched right up to her parents' bedroom, hopped right in the middle of her mom and dad, and said, "I love my home."
Okay, cheers. talking about her on her wedding night. So I really am in awe of the beautiful woman she's become. And I know that Tim and Emily are married now, but I've known Emily a little bit longer, so there are a couple of things that I know about Emily that I think are really important for Tim. First of all, when you get in an argument with a friend or family member, you need to be really careful about what you tell Emily, and it's not because she's not trustworthy. She's one of the most trustworthy people that I know. However, she can have a really hard time forgiving and forgetting when somebody hurts somebody that she loves. I can think of a couple friends and many ex-boyfriends that Emily still has some pretty serious beef with. And so even though I need to be careful about what I confide in Emily, this really shows one of her best qualities, and that's that she's one of the most loyal people that I know. And that's one of the things that I know will make her an amazing wife and life partner. Emily is 100% devoted to the people that she loves. And cares about and wants you on her side. Even if you don't want her to go to work for you, she will every time. Another thing about Emily that's really important and really special about her is that time is really the most important thing to her. Emily loves people and feels loved by people by spending time with them. Growing up, one of Emily's favorite times to spend time with me was really early on Saturday mornings. And so Emily would wake me up at the crack of dawn by sneaking into my room for dribbling her basketball right on top of my room. As a high schooler who was most likely out too late the night before, I wasn't always receptive to her request to spend time with me. However, as time went on, Emily has gotten her timing a little bit better, and she's no longer a morning person, and so I really learned to appreciate spending time with my little sister who was constantly following me around when she was little. Emily always puts the people that she cares about first. And I know that no matter how we're spending time together, whether we're out and about or watching a movie in which I fall asleep in the first 5 minutes and she forgives me every time, or just having sleepovers at mom and dad's, she always values that time and she puts her family before anything else. So Tim always appreciates the time that you have with her and know this is her way of life. In the beginning, I can't lie, I was a little bit skeptical of Tim. There was one really, really important character flaw that took us all a little bit in our little time together. First, Tim is a Vikings fan. Once we were able to look past that, though, we really quickly realized that Tim has a lot of qualities that make him a perfect fit for Emily. Tim is also really devoted to his family, and not only that, but he's shown all of us and Emily time after time that he's devoted to hers as well. He has somehow garnered all the approval from all of her sisters and her brother, which you can ask my brother-in-law Kyle, is not the easiest thing in the world to do. And I also love that Tim loves to spend time with Emily. I'm not sure if that's a natural thing or if Emily's kind of trained him to be that way, but either way, Tim always shows up, and that's important to her and to all of us. I want to leave you with just a quick verse as you start this new chapter in your lives together. It comes from Philippians 1:9. It says, "I pray that your love for each other will overflow more and more, and you keep on growing in your knowledge of yourself." So with all of that being said, welcome officially to the family, Tim, from all of us. We love you both so much. So raise your glasses with me to the newest members of Brandt.
All right, good evening, everybody. My name is Charlie. I'm Tim's oldest brother. I live down in Omaha. My wife, Danielle, in the back with our son, Isaac. My daughter, Tim's here right up front. We're excited to be here, excited for the day. Everything went perfect. Couldn't be happier for two of you. I guess I've known Tim for his entire life. Emily, I met her at the Sturgis Falls Parade, her executive. But I do remember quite vividly the conversations that Danny and I had for the entire drive home about how awesome she was and how stupid Tim would be if he messed it up. So I wrote a few notes here to make sure that I stay on topic. As I was jotting down ideas, I wanted to add some humor. My wife told me I'm not nearly as funny as I think I am. And based on my mom laughing the most, she's probably right again. So, thanks Mom, appreciate the support. So growing up, sports was something that was really important to the three of us brothers, especially golf. We really bonded. We always told ourselves we had the perfect foursome between the three of us and Dad. And I think that will last forever. On the golf course, it gave Al and I a lot of times to just roll our eyes, make fun of Tim. And we roll our eyes because Tim would always use the famous line that Dad says, followed by whatever he wanted to say at the time. Dad says I'm the best. Dad says I can get the farthest. Dad says I'm the best looking. Whatever it might be, but it caused Al and I to roll our eyes quite a few times. But I'm serious though, I think there's a lot of really important lessons that you can take into your marriage from the golf course. First lesson being, it's not always a bad thing to follow your brother's footsteps. Al and I got lucky enough to marry smart, beautiful women who are extremely supportive wives and incredible mothers. I think Emily is the perfect addition to that group and couldn't be happier to have you part of that team. She challenges you, she makes you a better version of yourself, so we're extremely happy to have her for you. The next lesson that golf taught us is the value of hard work. The game of golf isn't easy, neither is marriage. Today might be easy. Leading up to today, there's probably a lot of really easy things. But marriage isn't always easy. It takes hard work. Just like on the golf course, it takes a lot of time to roll in those 20 footers that Tim always makes, or like last weekend, hit every single green in regulation. It takes hard work and practice. Just like to have a successful marriage, it's going to take that hard work, that attention, and that focus. Thirdly, what I love about golf and what it can relate to your marriage is it's a game of integrity. You have to play an honest game. And in your marriage, Emily deserves a man who's going to be honest, a man who will lead her and make decisions honestly with integrity, and I think we'll do that for her. Finally, moving off the golf course into the backyard, the four of us sitting here, Zach, Al, me, and Tim, we played all the time together. Growing up, it was always Tim and I on the team against Al and Zach. I think in my mind, I always thought it was because it was the most athletic and the least athletic, just the two guys in the middle. But as I've gotten older, I came to realize that it's just the oldest and the youngest in the two middle. So it's more just an age thing. But that aside, we made fun of Tim a lot, but I want him to know, and I think he does know, that all of us, we've always had your back, we're on your team. All of us sitting up here are on your guys' team still, and you're getting the team for your marriage. All of us sitting here, all of us sitting in the crowd, and we just couldn't be happier for you. So I want y'all to just raise the glass. Congrats to Tim and Emily. Cheers.
Raised by both of your parents, and the foundations that you guys have, they That's exactly what your marriage will look like. So Tim, couldn't be happier for you today. Super proud to have you as a brother. Couldn't be happier to have you as a part of the family. You fit in perfectly with us all, and you're perfect for Tim. So hopefully you guys have something left in your glass. Bring them one more time to Tim and Emily.
Thank you. Hey, Tim, I need you to grab your father-in-law and escort him to the dance floor to dance with your beautiful bride. See, some of you remember. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm your woman.
Let all of Yes, that makes sense. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for them. All right.
Hey, Daryl, you want to have a seat, bro?
Daryl, ask me some questions.
I need
like,
all
interview
of my
me.
Married couple.
Tim and Emily, we love you guys so much, and we're so thankful that we were a part of your special day. We wish you a lifetime of love and happiness.
Tim and Emily, thank you for letting me and Margaret be a part of your special day, and we love you.
All right, Tim and Emily, wish Danny could be here with me. She took the kids home, but I wish you guys the best of luck. I know that me and Danny are always here supporting you 100%. If you guys need anything, you know who to call. Love you guys a ton. Thank you for letting me be part of your day. Love you guys.
Hi, Tim and Emily.
We love you so much.
Thanks for letting us be a part of your special day.
We wish you a lifetime of happiness.
And we hope you get really jealous of us because we're going to hang out all the time while you're on your honeymoon and you're not going to be with us.
Tim and Emily, super excited for you guys. It's been awesome to like be alongside you guys as you grow and like get to be involved. Some of my best memories the last couple years are old Chicago and just sharing Fireball at our house and just getting to grow alongside you guys.
Definitely. Just all those nights in old Chicago, slicing a beer, and we're able to watch you guys grow up together, and glad you guys are able to celebrate this night together.
Timely, it's been a great pleasure to watch you guys grow, like everybody else has said, but it really has, and I'm very excited for your future, and I'm having a ball tonight. You guys are throwing a great party to celebrate your marriage, and I look forward to greater things to come.
Tim, Emily, I just love you guys so much. My one word of advice is just whenever I come to visit, remember the couch order that we had at our house. Love you guys.
All right, and we have like, on the count of three, we're gonna give a big suey to you guys. So it's 1, 2, 3.
Suey!
Okay, Tim and Emily, my advice is to laugh at each other a lot. And then my second piece of advice is to ask questions when you're confused instead of being like angry automatically and assuming what they think, just to say, could you tell me more about that or explain more, because it helps a lot. Sunny.
All right. Emily.
Ready.
Emily. Tim. Don't exactly know what to say. I'm not married. Don't exactly know what goes into being married. But, Tim, don't tell her she's wrong, ever, because she'll never believe you. Emily, you'll always be a Vikings fan. It'll suck anyway, which way you have it. Tim, watch out. She will bite. And sometimes when she gets excited, she really knows how to punch hard. She'll go for the bone over your shoulder. As long as you keep that in mind, you guys will be good. Have fun in Mexico. Seth, out.
Alright. Timbo Jimbo, putting in pie, kissed the girls and made them laugh. When the boys came out to play, Timbo kissed them very, very much a lot. Seriously, Tim, we love you. I'm so excited to see you and Emily grow closer to Jesus, to each other. And Emily, I love you. You guys are a great fit for each other. Super excited for you guys.
Congrats, Tim and Emily. We're happy for you guys. Just looking forward to the many years ahead of having you, Emily, in our family. And just Tim, you're a great brother. Thanks for everything.
Yeah.
Hey, Tim and Emily, I just wanted to wish you guys all the best. And I just wanted to say, just keep the main thing, and that is that you have a relationship with God first and put Him first. And then as you do that, you'll draw closer to each other and to God as well. And that'll bless your relationship. I wish you all the best.
Yeah, same. And I know like I haven't been married very long, so like I can't give you that much advice. But just pray together a lot. That will be like so helpful in everything. But yeah, love you guys.
Love you guys.
We love you, and I think you should just pull. I mean, like I said, not going to bed mad. That's a big thing. And just not holding a grudge.
No.
Forgive each other. And have fun on your honeymoon. We love you. Love you. I hope your butt tattoo is still on.
Thanks, guys, for inviting me today. I knew that Tim was the right one for you the first time I met him, and guess I was right. Anywho, I wish you love and luck in your life. Not that you need anything, because you guys are gonna lucky together. So enjoy.
We love you guys, and I would say just my, I don't know, there's so many pieces of advice I might have after.
She's already offered some.
But I've offered you some, remember Christmas night? I won't say it again in case Mom watches this, but it was a very important piece of advice. And I would say just go with it and remember that you love each other at the bottom of everything that you do.
Transparency, honesty.
Be transparent and be honest.
Perfect.
Love you.
Okay, you guys, this is a super, super fun night. Everybody had a blast. We're so proud of both of you. We love you so much. Have never seen Tim happier, Emily, and it thrills us, actually. Yep. It just thrills us.
Yep. And we are so happy for both of you. We wish you the best, and if you ever need anything, we're always here for you. We're always in your corner. But we love you both very much, and we are so proud of both of you.
Yep.
Okay, Tim and Emily, I just want to tell you that you need to just, Daryl, I don't even know what to say.
Ken, that's not a good one. Okay. Hey, guys, what we wanted to say was you guys need to grow spiritually together. That's the most important thing. Make sure you're in the Word. Tim, be a good leader, and Emily, be a good follower.
And really keep the putt-putts down to a minimum. Thank you.
Ken.